enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's tool review, we're looking at this edge finder or centre finder for a milling machine. It's a titanium coated high speed steel and it has a spring down the middle that holds it together. So what I want to do today is see how accurate this is, what it will repeat to, and whether it can find the centre of a hole. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're looking at this edge finder from Banggood. It's titanium coated, has a spring up the middle and two polished faces which run concentric to each other. That part there is just a pin to hold the spring. And on the end there's a brass cap. On the website it says to run this at 400 RPM. It's made from high speed steel and it's non-magnetic. So obviously when you're trying to find the edge of a component, if it's steel you don't want this magnetic, so it just clicks to it. Overall length is about 90 mm, 3.5 inches. At the end, this is 4 mm diameter. This one is 10 mm diameter and it's reduced here so it won't touch the edge of something. And the shaft on this end is 10 mm, so it'll fit a 10 mm collet. So we'll put this in the milling machine and see how accurate it is. I fitted an ER20 collet and the collet nut on the end, and I've pushed the edge finder body nearly to the end of the collet on the inside. So I can fit this onto the spindle. Tighten it up. So I've selected the speed at, it should be around 280. Let's have a look. And I'll just position it on the edge of this block of aluminium. Right, so what I'm going to do, start it off, just touch the edge, and when this edge finder indicates it's on the edge, I'll set my direct readouts to zero. You can see here the edge finder's just kicked out at the top here. I'll back off and rerun it. I'll move it in. It's just kicked there. What's happening, the top part just kicks across and that tells you you're on the edge. You can see here, if you look at this part here, you can see when it touches the face, at the moment you can see it's running true, the top's running true with a spindle. I'll move it in a bit. And you can see there it's just kicked out to one side. .005 different to the last time. Come down to the same depth. touch it on this side. Zero it. It's just kicked 0.005 of a millimeter difference from the first one. So what I'll do now is I've put a parallel strip in the vise with the ground face, which will probably be a bit more fairer to the product because this face is fairly rough where I've been measuring. So if I just touch it on the edge there, there it's gone again. That's within 5 microns of the first one. That's kicked. That's within 5 microns again. I think this is a bit fairer on a ground surface rather than a rough edge. But yeah, that seems to find the edge within 5 microns or 10 microns if you do 5 either side, 10 microns, which is probably good enough for most milling operations. I'm just going to see now whether I can find the centre of this hole. So I'll lower it down into the hole. I'll move it till it touches the edge. Now in a hole it will be more difficult because normally when it kicks it runs along the edge of the workpiece, but the hole is holding it to the centre line. That's just kicked over. Zero my DRO. Move it till it touches the other edge. So we half the X on the digital readout. Move it to zero. And we do the same in the Y axis. Zero. Move it the other side. That's kicked there. Half the Y and move that to zero. That puts the spindle in the centre of the bore. What I've done is just put the dial indicator in the spindle. I'll lower that into the bore. I'll set it to zero. It's nearly on zero anyway. I'll turn it round. You can see there it's 0.01. This is the back of the milling machine and the reading is 0.03. This is the other side and it's 0.025, and back to the front and it's back to zero. So on the average, the edge finder found the centre of the hole to within 0.015, so I'd have to move it 0.015 to be on centre line, which is less than a thou. Well, I must say I'm surprised how accurate that is, and it costs less than £5, so I couldn't even make it for that price. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it, hope you found it interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.